Hey everybody, this is Brian here from Let's Play Quietly, and I am playing some more Everybody's Golf. Before we go into our latest match today, I'm just going to go to the store and see if there is anything worth picking up. Most of this stuff looks like it was here last time. I guess that's new. But nothing really super exciting. Side spinner, sand viper. So these balls are different types of golf balls that will be better for certain parts of your game. So these are good for approach shots. These are good for putting side spin on the ball. These are really good out of the traps. And these ones are better probably out of the rough, now that I think about it, so. But nothing super exciting to pick up today. You actually earn different pieces of clothing when you beat other players, so. We're going to jump in and play around today and see what we have. We have Eagle City, which is the course we've been playing, but I think this is the other nine. So we're going to jump in. I am using a club that is more accurate. You can see on the top where it says the type of clubs that I'm checking out. So that's the standard one. This is for distance. This is accuracy. And I think this is for better spin. And spin is something that I don't always have a lot of luck with, so. And then for golf balls, I have the standard, I have the beginner, and I have the ultra approach. Actually, I'm going to pick that one, which is probably going to be less distance. Oh, and I picked the spin club. Okay. Well, this is going to be an adventure because I haven't used these spin clubs yet. But my guess is that they are less powerful, but have better control in terms of spin. And I haven't really played this game since the last time I recorded. So I expect there's going to be some bad timing to start. But let's see. That one was pretty good. I love that you get to practice your swing while the loading screen is on. Anywhere in that white or pink area on the accuracy meter is fine. Okay, I have actually, in one spectacular round, I birdied every hole on this nine. That is not going to be the case today, but
it's a par five.
It's a par five we're starting off with, and it is a slight dog left, so I'm just going to start right in the middle. And give it a ride. That's not a bad first tee shot. But I didn't get it far enough out to the right, so I have to now worry about the corner. I mean, it's not terrible. That tree should be out of my... I shouldn't have to worry about hitting that tree. But I'm going to go to my driver, and I'm actually going to see if I can drive it down there, although I think that might be water. That is water down there. So if I mishit this, it's going to go in the water. So this could be an adventure. Let's see what happens. Oh, yeah, perfect.
Beautiful.
Stay left, stay left, stay left. Get on that green. Holy cow. Okay, that was a really good shot, even though it rolled a little bit too far. We killed that shot. Okay.
Chance for an eagle.
This is for eagle. You see, it's going to break to the left as it gets closer to the hole.
A break to the left?
I'm really bad at playing the break in this game. I'm still figuring it out, but we're going to have to hit it harder, too, because it's uphill. Probably not enough. Oh, it went in. Okay. That is awesome. An eagle is a great way to start the round, so we are now in first place. We got a par 4. This one's fairly straight. I'm going to drop over here and let it rip. The wind is just slightly in our face, so this should be a decent tee shot. Oh, it hit a branch. Okay, but it landed on the fairway, so we're okay. 228 yards. Okay, that's actually perfect. So now is the first real opportunity to put spin on the club. We're going to go a little bit past the distance and put some spin on it. I didn't hit it far enough, but it's going to sit nice when shot. I do. Oh, wow. I didn't even hit it accurate enough. Sit down, sit down, sit down. I'm going to see if I can putt from here. I don't know if it'll let me. Oh, it will. Okay, we're going to putt from here. This is for birdie, I think. It's going to break right, and it's going to slow down because of the rough. So we are going to go just slightly above. Boom. Awesome. Okay, so I'm still able to putt in from off the green, which is good. So the third hole is going to be a par 3. And this one, we really don't have a lot of green to work with. So it has to be a decent shot. We're going to drop here. We have a 4-iron. I wonder if we went 5-iron. 141. So I could hit it short and let it... Yeah, I'm going to do this. This might be short, though. But we'll see. But the wind's at our back. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Perfect.
You look stronger already.
Okay, that was good. Now can we convert it for a birdie? It's going to break right or left early, and then it's going to smooth out. So let's stay here. And it is flat. Might not be enough. Oh, wow. Okay. You'll notice that was like a lucky roll. And the thing is that you get those rolls if you make long putts and things like that. It actually levels up your ability to make shots that are close. Like, they'll give you the benefit of the doubt if you've made those shots before. So we are going to put a little power on this one and see if I can get it actually down towards the green. So, but I have to hit it. Oh, okay, I did. When you use the power shot, you have to be really accurate, because if you are not, then you will actually, this could be in the trap, by the way. Oh, and it is, but it's not buried, so we're okay. The lie isn't bad. And it's going to go left, but the green is breaking right, so I'm actually going to leave it alone. And let's see. Get up there. Stay near. Oh, that was pretty good. We didn't see how it ended up because that woman was standing in my way, but okay. This should be... Get in there. We're doing pretty good through 4 holes so far. Hole number 4 is a dog leg. Ooh, it's a double dog. That's kind of like a... Looks like a boneless chicken tender. Alright, we're going to go left to begin with. And then, because we want... Oh, that was a bad hit. Just stay on the fairway, because on the way in, we want to have a clearer look. Okay, see, Because I didn't hit that well, I now have left myself this tree to deal with. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to hit it a little bit to the right, and we're going to give it some spin to make it come back in. So you'll see what I mean in a second if I do it right. So I have 80 yards to go. We're going to hit it about perfect. Oh, I might not have done that right. Oh, see, you can see it curving. And there it goes. And now it just needs to sit. Okay, that was good. So the side spin is really helpful when you have a obstacle in your way. So now I just have to make this putt, which is flat. And I didn't hit it enough. Darn it, and I mishit it. This is probably not going to go in. I did everything I could do to miss that putt, but...
Hole 15. It's a par 3.
A par 3 on hole 15. Okay. So, let's see what we got. 145 yards, 154, and it's down 5 feet. We're going to put a little bit of spin on this. Oh, should we? You know what? Oh, no, we should. All right, we're going to do that. We're going to go almost... I probably hit this too far, but it's going to hopefully spin back a little bit. Spin back, spin back.
No, Father.
And the reason it didn't spin the way that I wanted it to is because I think it bounced before the green, which kind of took the spin out of it. If I had landed it clearly on the green, I would have been all right. It's going to break right a lot, I think. We'll see. And it's uphill, so let's just... It's probably not enough. Stay, 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 stay. Okay. But that was a good layup. We should hopefully tap that in. So that's our first par. However, we are still averaging one under for every hole because of the eagle that I made on the first hole. Par 4 is going to be a slight dog right, but we are going to land it. That's probably good right there. Not trying to do anything fancy, and I screwed it up. Come on, just land in the fairway and stay in the fairway. Okay, good. 111 yards. We are going to have an 8-iron. It is uphill, and the wind's in our face. So, I did put backspin on that. Nice. Let's hope it actually gets nice there, or it's going to be very short. Stay, stay, stay. Okay, that was pretty good.
Could make a birdie.
This is pretty straight.
Don't risk it.
Get in that. There we go. Perfect. Okay. We have 2 holes left, and let's see,
it's a par 4,
par 4, kind of straight. I'm going to drop it here. Normally they don't let 5 people tee off at the same time, so I'm going to use a power shot, and we're going to hopefully not mishit it. Okay, that was good. So I blasted that, and I should get some good bounce out of that. Yep. I just want to get clear of that tree on the left so that I'm not contending with it when I hit my approach shot. And it looks like we're going to be okay because that's a very high tree. So as long as I don't hit the tree itself, we should be good. Now, that is 87 to 93. What if we went with the alternate wedge, 85 yards? I'm actually going to do that. Oh, I hit it okay. It's gotta sit though. It's gotta sit down. Sit, 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 sit. Okay, that was good. A lot of times I like to go with a shorter club and let the ball feed to the hole rather than trying to take a longer club and take something off of it, because it's easier to just hit a club full strength. Let's get that in there. There we go. Okay, we have 1 hole left. And I don't know what it is. It's a par 5. Okay. So we just need a good first shot here. I'm tempted to use a power shot, but if I screw it up, it's really going to hurt me. So let's just... Oh, see? And I would have screwed it up.
Oh, no.
That's actually a bad shot. Get out of those trees. This could be trouble. Keep bouncing. Okay, good. We can actually come over from that if you look. It won't let me take anything more than a 3-iron. But that's not bad, because I was able to blast it out there. It's on the fairway. Stay on the fairway. Stay right there. Stay right there. Okay. And the pin is straight ahead, so we're okay. We're good for our third shot here. We're going to go down to here, and we're going to... That was good. If it's not enough, it's going to end up in the sand trap, which is going to be trouble. Which is exactly what we didn't want. Look at, if you look in the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see how buried this ball is. It looks like an egg yolk. So this is really bad because it's going to affect our shot big time. And we really don't know how it's going to come out. So I'm going to play to the left. I'm going to give it something extra. And we're going to hope that we hit this okay. See how short that was? I should have hit it a lot harder.
Careful.
Because it took everything just to get out. And look at the break that we're playing with now. We could actually bogey this hole off of how bad this... I'm probably playing too much break, but it is uphill, so we're going to do this. We'll see.
You go on.
Okay, that wasn't terrible for how bad I mishit the accuracy. It's flat. Oh my god, that was terrible. Wow. One bogey to end the round. That's not the way that you want to end the round. However, and I didn't get to beat my record on this course, but I'm pretty much, I still destroyed the rest of the field. So that's good. And let's see if we unlocked anything decent. See what our stats are.
What a result.
We had a great drive, but our impact and fairway hits were down. My accuracy wasn't that good this time around, so what did I get for items?
Nice.
I got a shirt, I got some cool pants, oh, I got a nice pair of jean shorts. Maybe I'll break out the jorts in my next round. And we unlocked some coins and turbo spin club clubs. So we unlocked new clubs. And we got a new gallery member, which is cool. He used one ultra approach ball. Oh! So those are consumable. I didn't realize that. Okay, so you can use the standard golf balls forever, but if you use a special ball... So I should save those for tournaments that I know I need to score really high in, or if it's a course that's really... demanding in terms of accuracy. That's good to know. But that is going to wrap up this particular video. So if you like this video, then please click like and subscribe to our YouTube page, and I will be back again soon with more Everybody's Golf.